Jay Haynes of the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and today in this video, I'm going to show how to create this looping Starfield animation in HitFilm. All right, I'm going to start by creating a new composite shot, and it'll be 30 seconds long, 24 frames per second, although those are irrelevant. Click OK, and then I'm going to create a new plane layer, and I'm going to make this plane white. Click OK. The reason it's white is because it works better with the Starfield animation that I'm going to use, which will be the atomic particles. I will search for atomic particles layer only and drag that onto the white plane. And then opening up the properties, I will select the preset of Starfield. And there it is, you see. So now I'm going to add a new point, and I will make this point three-dimensional, which will automatically add a camera. If it doesn't, just say, yes, I want a camera. Opening up the atomic particles effect again, if I twirl open the particle placement under position, I want to transform from that new point. All right, so now I can take this camera and I can sort of push it through the Starfield, right? And I'm actually going to start at 4,000. So that it has plenty of room, and I will end this at zero so that it has flowed all the way into this. Now the problem is that there's not any Starfield here, right, in the first part of this. So what I will do is I will take both of these and I will just duplicate them again, okay? And then on the second particle effect, I will go ahead and set that to Starfield. And again, under particle placement position, I will go ahead and set that to the new point. But here's going to be the thing. The new point, instead of setting it at position of zero, which is where it naturally is, I'm going to set this to a position of 3,000, which will push it 3,000 pixels towards the camera. So now you can see that the camera pushes through the second plane of Starfield, and then it pushes through the first plane of Starfield, okay? So now all I have to do is find out where they match, right? And so looking, look at this, right? Let me back up just slightly. Here, you can see that these two stars are perfect. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to, under the camera position, I'm going to go ahead and add a keyframe there. And then, and you can see there it is, I'm going to push forward until I see that again. And here they come, they are right there. All right, and now I'm going to set a keyframe there. All right, so now what I can do is, at the beginning of this, and let me zoom in just slightly here, I'm just going to pull this keyframe back and replace that one. And then at the end, I'm just going to pull this one forward to replace that one. Okay, now, the thing is that I need that to actually go one further past where I'm at. So that way, when this approaches there and then goes to the beginning, it's the next frame. See? So now I have a perfectly looping situation, right? It's there to there. That's the end of the previous one. That's the beginning of this one. And you can see it if I select loop playback and then start playing from the end to get there and boom, and it just slides right on through. And so now I can go ahead and render this out and I have a beautiful 30 second looping animated Starfield. There is a video that I did creating this Starfield that adds a whole bunch of really cool effects to it and makes it look even nicer. So I'm going to leave that up here in the corner. And if you like this kind of thing, do me a favor, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and share it with all your friends. Thanks for watching.